Welcome, my name is Sjoerd Jansma, and as the title mentions, I'm going to talk about testing the materials of a reinforcement thermoplastic pipe for the use of high pressure hydrogen applications. Here you see an overview of the Netherlands, and this is mainly to show you that a lot of hydrogen applications are currently involved, ideas to use this green hydrogen as a sustainable economy. In red is Amsterdam, where this plastic pipe conference should or is held. And it has a large industry cluster which can use this green hydrogen as a feedstock. In blue is the Eemshaven, and the Eemshaven is where this current project is focusing on. Here you see an overview of the Eemshaven. In blue is an already existing hydrogen pipeline, and this pipeline is used to fuel public buses. In orange is hydrogen grid the harbor wants to realize, and this hydrogen grid is used to fuel all those different facilities which can use the hydrogen in their feedstock. To realize this hydrogen grid, we can use several systems, and one system they are currently studying is the RTP. Here you see the pipe. The RTP system is proven applicable for oil and gas applications in both practice and via certification. For instance, the API 15S, following API 15S, this system is applicable up to 90 bars. The current hydrogen grid is intended to be operating at 42 bars, which is considerably lower. This new application is hydrogen. And because it's hydrogen, there are two topics still that need to be studied. One is regarding the materials compatibility. The harbor wants to check whether these materials are compatible with hydrogen. And the second is the permeation of hydrogen through the system. Before I can discuss these topics, we need to consider the RTP. RTP is a multi-layer pipe, which has different layers, and from the inside out, it consists of a polyethylene liner, an aluminium gas-tight layer, a reinforcement layer, and a cover. And basically all those questions concern all those different materials. Well, first off is the check for the material compatibility. We used dog bones or strings of the different materials and exposed them to the 42 bars of hydrogen during over 2000 hours. Afterwards, the samples were extracted from this environment and they were tested using a tensile test, and we saw no change in mass, dimensions or the tensile properties of these materials, which successfully concluded this check of the material compatibility. The next topic is permeation. Permeation is the transport of a gas, liquid or vapor through a material. Permeation depends on several factors, of which the dimensions of the barrier layer, the permeation coefficient of the materials, of the individual materials, and the pressure, the partial pressure difference of the hydrogen over the system. There are two things that complicate the permeation experiments. First of them is the pressure. Here you see a schematic overview of the permeation process. In gray is the polymeric material, and in dark gray we have the polymeric chains. The hydrogen is depicted by these yellow dots is within the free volume between the molecular chains of the polymer. Due to pressure, the material can be compressed. And as such, the mobility of the polymeric chains can change, and therefore the mobility of the hydrogen molecules can change. And this alters the permeation behavior between low pressures or high pressures. And in order to tackle this problem, we decided to test the system at 42 bars, which is the intended operating pressure of this grid. In this case, we know several permeation behaviors of the materials. Several permeation behaviors are unknown, and we test the materials. The first method is the individual layer method. In the individual layer, we consider each layer as an individual and calculate how this material influences the permeation behavior of the entire system. For some materials, we can do this because we already have experience with those materials. for other materials. However, we can't do this and we need to test these materials in order to gain the parameters by which we can calculate the permeation behavior of the system. Those individual layers were individually tested. We used small sheet specimens and we applied them inside the chamber. The chamber has a primary side, and in this primary side we applied the 42 bar of hydrogen pressure. The chamber also has a secondary side, which is isolated by this test specimen. And the secondary side has atmospheric conditions, as what you would expect in practice. Due to permeation, the hydrogen flows from the primary side to the secondary side. And we measure the accumulation of this hydrogen at the secondary side. We do this for the unknown individual layers, and via this we can calculate the entire system. The actual is one of the blocks we used, and as you can see, it's a big metal, solid metal disc, really used to test actually a small polymer sheet. Via this, as mentioned, we can calculate the permeation behavior of the entire system, and we have some assumptions. So if we consider the operating pressure of 42 bars of hydrogen, we consider ambient temperature, and we consider 400 meters of pipe, which is one roll of RTP. The total hydrogen emission is almost 10 liters per year. The second method of deviating this number is by measuring the complete system. Here you see the test for the complete system. We have the pipe, and we place a metal jacket pipe around this pipe. We fill the pipe with 42 bars of hydrogen pressure. The jacket pipe again has atmospheric conditions, and we measure the accumulation of hydrogen which flows from the inside of the pipe through the pipe wall to the outside and is captured by this jacket pipe. Not only did we measure the pipe, but the system also consists of an inline coupling and an end fitting, and those were also included in this measurement. The inline coupling was within jacket pipe 5 and 2, and the end fittings was within jacket pipe 4 and 1. And as we measure the accumulation of hydrogen over time, we can derive the permeation rate of these components of the system. This is shown in this graph. On the y-axis, we have the accumulation of hydrogen, and on the x-axis, we have the time in days. And once we perform these calculations, we get these numbers. On the bottom, around 0.03 and 0.05 milliliters per day per meter is the permeation of the pipe. In the middle, around 0.3 and 0.4 milliliters per day is the permeation of the inline coupling. And above, at 0.4 to 15 milliliters a day is the permeation behavior of the end fitting. Well, this 15 milliliters per day is hardly shown in this graph. On the right, near the y-axis, we have the first measuring point. In the paper shows the whole graph. The 15 milliliters per day seems quite large, especially considering the other five measurements, but in fact, it's still a permeation process and no leakage. This would result in much larger accumulation of hydrogen. After the experiment was finished, we disassembled carefully this end fitting in order to determine how this permeation behavior could be so large, but no inconsistencies were discovered. But following this measurement, with the same assumptions as the first individual layer method, so the 42 bar hydrogen pressure, which is the operating conditions, the ambient temperature and one roll of 400 meters, we calculated with the individual layer method almost 10 liters per year of hydrogen emission. Measuring this complete system, this would account for almost 8 liters per year of hydrogen emission. And this basically gives the harbor or the operator a feeling for how much hydrogen emission is compelled for this entire system. So they can calculate economic losses. They can determine whether this hydrogen could accumulate in a room, in a closed room or something like that. So they can provide safety measures for this. Finally, to put these numbers in perspective, the 400 meters of pipe contains almost of over 200,000 liters of hydrogen. So per year, less than 0.005% is lost due to this permeation behavior. In the end, these results were used in a covenant between KIWA and SOILFORCE stating the applicability of these RTP. And also, for instance, the risk assessment, the QRA, has been finalized, and all signs are green for using this RTP system for the intended trajectory. And with this, we came to the end of my presentation, and I would like to thank you for your attention.